hip hop. Hip hop is a culture, a tool that I use to uplift on instead of using my fist. Ain't no future if the present ain't using my gift in a world where rules don't exist. If rules don't exist, the truth don't exist. The youth worship money, do anything to get rich. The youth worship money, do anything to get rich, even God trying. Now that don't make any sense. Hip hop has started in the 70s in South Bronx, New York. And it was a way for African American, Caribbean, and Latino youth to express themselves and deter negative activity. And this was done through four elements: breakdancing, DJing, graffiti art, and singing. Hip hop is in a state of emergency. Little green lies, rappers telling fibs about the trap, sending mixed messages to kids. For the love of money, don't got no will to live? Well, you gonna lose your life from trying to do it big. Basically, hip hop has turned into something very materialistic. This is the era I grew up in, the golden era of hip hop, where you had groups like A Tribe Called Quest, where you had De La Soul, you had Queen Latifah's, and they spoke on things like embracing your heritage and being positive. So that influenced my movement as to the present day. That gentleman right there is Rakim. He never really cursed in his music. So that inspired me as well. But the Keepers of the Art used to throw an Akron Hip Hop Showcase here, and I had won an online contest to open up for Rakim. Great experience, great experience. This right here is the old me. This was throwback minus. Wild hair. I didn't always do positive music. I was just like any teenager, just trying to find my way, figure out how can I get into this music industry. This right here was Live 3 Live, the actual event of the Akron Hip Hop Showcase. Had an overwhelming response. I had kids coming up to me because I came with all positive music. They wanted autographs signed. The parents, they assured me that what I was doing was what the youth needed. Very powerful visual right there. That there is basically uplifting our youth. And I had to make a vow, I took a stand. And I said, I want to positively impact our youth through hip hop, provide safe outlets and platforms to empower them. Alienation, the brand. Still blinded by color, but we should love one another. At the end of the day, we're all brothers. Alienation is a brand I created and trademarked for positive, unique individuals who dare to be different. And this was my way of getting youth to look at positivity as something cool. This was an article that was done by Malcolm Abram for the Akron Union Journal. And this was when I first came to him, letting him know the different things I wanted to do with hip hop and positivity and how I could impact the youth. So he wrote an article on it. And from that point, I was able to come up with an idea called a New Way Project. A New Way Project basically teaches youth a new way of doing things. A new way I'm trying to pay, found my purpose in life, now I'm not afraid to say hip hop is kind of vague, I'm taking a stand and it starts today. This was our first talent show that we threw, and that was at Hope Academy. And we challenged all of the youth to come with positive messages. So when they did that, it really showed them a different side of hip hop, because they were so used to all the negative messages. They thought they had to talk about violence, you know, sex, drugs, alcohol, things of that nature. This right here, this is when WKYC had interviewed me at one of the talent shows at Hope Academy. This was back in 2012. And Robert Sabota called me B-. But it was sunny. This is at Middlebury Academy in Akron, Ohio, where we had kids participating with the Keep Akron Beautiful. So we want to teach them outreach as well, because they got to give back to their community. You know, doing things like this is actually fun to them when they started doing it. And it's teaching them good work habits, good work ethic. This young man, his name is Devin Goodwin, and he was one of my star pupils in a creative writing class that I had held. He's now at LA. But this young man told me that he grew up with like brothers that were in and out of jail, And he said, when you came to our school and you started talking about positivity and you made rap sound cool, he was like, it totally changed my life. This is my latest single. This is a plug, guys. Been on iTunes, Amazon, Google Play, all digital distribution outlets. Appreciate your support and positivity because I'm for the kids. We shot a music video here for Take It Higher, and we covered a lot of different social issues like homelessness, violence, also like with the kids walking around with their pants hanging down. We had a little funny skit about that as well. Okay, this was the Barbadan Boys and Girls Club, and these group of kids are actually in the music video. So I first came there to talk to them about pursuing their dreams, bullying, and entrepreneurship. So I had a great time with those kids, made sure they got my project, and if they listened to that CD, I bet you it changed their minds. This right here, I was with DJ Adam from WZIP. I had contacted him and wanted to do an interview and just come on here and talk about some of the concerns I had in the community. And he was open arms, so I went on there and got an interview, then got the song playing. Take It Higher is the most requested song in station history, they said. I couldn't believe it. Like, positivity. Okay. This is Big Love Fest. Anybody go to Big Love Fest? Man, had a blast. That was at the Akron, that was at the Summit Art Space. It was so many different arts and crafts. It was an awesome time. So, in closing, I came up with an acronym for hip hop. So hip hop is spelled H-I-P-H-O-P. What I want you to take from here today, not looking at hip hop as something negative anymore. I want you to look at hip hop as, hey, I'm positive. Let's heal our planet. Yeah.